So the last thing I wanted to talk about was just representing other things like images and music and whatnot, because going back to the first idea in this numbering systems topic, the computer only speaks ones and zeros, and yet the computer is right now showing you a video, it's playing sound for you. How does it make those things happen? And initially, I don't know what initially what means. It could have been, let's say that the only options we have on the monitor to show any colors for each pixel are, we only had 4 bits to represent them. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and I can start out with a 0, 0, 0, 0, and I can go to a 0, 0, 0, 1, and then a 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, and so on and so forth. And I could say, well, this one is black. This color is red. This color is green. Whenever you see this pattern, that means green. Whenever you see this one, that means yellow. Whenever you see this one, that means blue. And so on and so forth. Well, how many colors could we represent with 4 bits? Again, it's binary, so that's the base, 2. 2 to the number of digits is 4. 2 to the 4 is going to be 16. We could represent 16 colors, which in the world of colors is not very much. So it used to be that we had, for example, 8-bit color. Okay, with 8 bits, 2 to the 8th, then we could have, what's that going to be? Probably 256. 256 different colors. I don't know if that's right. Let me verify. I need my fancier calculator. 2 to the 8th. Yeah, 256. So we could represent 256 different colors, which is pretty good. That's a lot of different colors. You picture a box of crayons. That's a lot of colors, right? Well, apparently, the human eye can see something in the neighborhood of 16 million different colors, can differentiate between 16 million different colors or some crazy amount, which is to think about what the human body can do is just absolutely amazing. So you see, for example, if I go pull up my, let's see if I can do this, my display settings, I'm on Windows 10, so I don't know if I can do this. This is something I've never tried on here. Customize your display. It used to be that you could change the amount of, and maybe you still can, I just don't know where it is. You can change the number of bits. And for a while there was 16-bit color, but what we use now a lot of times is 32-bit color. And with 32 bits of color, so 2 to the 32nd, we get 4 billion different types of colors. Well, actually, what we use is 24-bit. I'm getting ahead of myself. It's just the way it's stored. So the actual number that we're using is 16 million different colors that we can represent using 24-bit color. And it talks about it in the textbook, but we used to have red, green, blue monitors, right? And in a red, green, blue monitor, the first 8 bits were how much red? Wow. Sorry. Were how much red, how much green. I gotta quit pushing the button. I'm gonna drive myself nuts here. And how much blue. Okay. So each of those got 8 bits each. Can I control Z? There we go. Thank goodness for, when was the last time you thanked control Z? It does an amazing work. So each of those is represented by 8 bits. 8 times 3 is 24. Okay. So what happens on a computer? We get a resolution, let's say, of, like I'm recording this video at, what is it, 1280 by 720, I think. That's the resolution of the video. Okay, so what that means is on this particular screen you're looking at, well, it depends on your resolution actually, but the resolution I'm recording it at is 1280. Calculator works sometimes, sometimes it doesn't. So there are 921,600 pixels in this particular video. And the more pixels in an area, the better the quality of the resolution. Because if you picture it this way, let's say there were 10 pixels and I could only color each one. This is like the old, when they used to have the video board with like the little lights. So like you could make out there was a person there and sometimes you could even make out who it was, but it was, you know, really hard to see because there just were only so many bulbs on the screen. Well, the more pixels we can get to the screen, the more, the better the quality of the video. And so 921,600 pixels on the screen. Each of those pixels is represented by 24 bits. And so if we take that number and multiply it by 24, that's the number of bits that are stored on the screen to make up a picture. Again, these numbers get kind of mind-boggling. But we usually don't deal in bits, we usually deal in bytes. So we'll divide that by 8. And what that means is to store a picture of this video, it's going to require 2,764,800 bytes of memory. Okay? And we don't usually talk about stuff in terms of bytes. We talk about it in terms of megabytes, and mega is a million. And so this particular screen to store this information would be 2.76 megabytes to store an image of this screen. Okay? Well, what if it's a video? Well, let's say the video is 30 frames per second. So to store, let's say 10 seconds of video. So I'll multiply this by 30 and then multiply that by 10. And then again, we're looking at this in the millions. And so a megabyte isn't a million, it's 1,000. Right? Where did I get a million? I can't believe I'm having to look this up here, but I'm... Yeah, because gig is a million. No, gig is a billion. Mega, meaning computers. Yeah, kilos a thousand. Oh my goodness. Yeah, kilos a thousand, megas a million. I was right the first time. I don't know why I questioned myself. There we go. So kilos a thousand, megas a million, gigas a billion, teras a trillion. Okay, so we're good. So 829 megabytes to store 10 seconds of video at this resolution. Now this video is going to end up being about 10 minutes long. So let's divide that by 10. And then multiply that by 60 times 10. And we get a really big number here. And so, and then we'll divide that by million. So this video is going to be somewhere in the neighborhood of 50 megabytes in size, if I get done talking anytime soon. All right, so that's where sizes come from. Each one of these little tiny pixels, if you look really close at the screen, you can see little tiny dots. A number of times. So if we refresh 20 times a second, 20 times a second, the computer's telling each of those little pixels what color they need to be. And it's all stored in memory, and that's why video gets so intense. When you're running video, it's really hard on the computer, and that's why a really good video card can help a lot and alleviate from the processor, because there's a huge burden placed on the video just to make the images come up on the screen. And you can start to get a feel for, okay, so we just had, you know, Blu-ray movies, now we're moving to 4K movies. If you're storing that much more data, it can't fit on a DVD. They're going to have to come up with some other way of doing it. And so it may be through streaming content, digital content, that you need to download and whatnot. But every image that we store has a size. And it all comes back to this math, you know, representing bits, binary, all that kind of stuff. Sound, by the way, is the same way. It just isn't used as much. So we use 16-bit sound. So 16 bits gives us around that 65,000 different amplitudes. And then we can make sound. We can represent sound that way. But it's all done with ones and zeros. Everything is ones and zeros in the world of computers. And so maybe this sound, you know, duh, is one. You know, 0000, and then duh is 0001, and so on and so forth. They just assign a number to each sound, and that was really stupid. But they assign a number to each sound, and that's how we get sound out of a machine when the machine is just understanding ones and zeros. So hopefully that's all interesting. I know this is a longer video, and you're probably ready to be done with this stuff, but it really is interesting how everything happens. The fact that, I mean, you need to every day give your computer a hug and say, thank goodness for working, because it really is amazing. There is a lot going on in these machines. And hopefully this has been of some interest to you. And the numbering stuff is really good, particularly when you get into assembler programming. You need to know all about hexadecimal in particular. So anyway, Spencer out. I need a nap.